Hi, I'm Dr. Matheson Harris with Utah Oculoplastic Consultants in Salt Lake City, Utah. Skin cancer of the eyelids is relatively common, especially in the West where lots of us spend lots of time in the sun. The eyelid skin is the thinnest and most sensitive skin on your body, and as a result, this is the first area of your face to show change from sun damage and aging. Unfortunately, solar damage and other environmental toxins cause the skin to age and can cause cancer. The presence of a bump or growth on the eyelid that is enlarging, bleeds, or forms a scab should be looked at by a medical doctor trained in recognizing these types of growths. Basal cell skin cancers represent 90% of eyelid tumors and grow slowly over months to years. They usually appear as a pearly nodule or bump that eventually starts to break down and bleed or scab. Despite being a cancer, these tumors don't spread to distant areas, but mainly just continue to grow and infiltrate the surrounding tissue, causing a lot of damage. They can be cured by a simple surgical removal followed by reconstruction of the defect left behind if they are caught early. Squamous cell tumors are less common but are more aggressive. They can eventually spread to other parts of the body. Early detection and removal are key. They will appear as a rough, crusty, or red spot where the skin is changing or breaking down. These are harder to spot sometimes, so it's important you see your doctor regularly if you have a history of skin cancer, so they aren't missed. Melanoma is the least common but most dangerous eyelid skin cancer. It usually appears as an irregular brown spot. If left to grow, it can invade into the deep tissues and spread to other parts of the body. Melanoma can be lethal, so have any suspicious spots checked out as soon as you notice them. Skin cancers often need to be removed by a surgeon who can also reconstruct the eyelid or area where the tumor was removed. We often perform small tumor removals in the clinic, but often we must use a surgical facility with an on-site pathologist who can immediately examine the specimen to ensure the whole tumor was removed. Other times, we work together with a dermatologist specializing in Mohs surgery, where they completely remove the tumor and we reconstruct the defect they create. The most important thing to remember with skin cancer is to have any suspicious growth checked out while it's small. The larger it gets, the bigger the surgery to remove it and close the defect. If you have any questions about skin cancer, email me directly or call our office for a visit. Thanks for visiting Utah Oculoplastic Consultants. We look forward to helping you feel and look your best.